الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Good morning brothers and sisters, Instagram fam, friends and followers of Safi. And welcome to another episode in our running series of short lectures, Revert Reflections. And today we'll be continuing our discussion on the concept of religious reform and whether or not it is needed in Islam. So brothers and sisters, one of the causes for calls for religious reform throughout history and in the present day is the apparent conflict between religion and science. Previously, brothers and sisters, religious institutions like the church made assertions like the earth is flat, which were disproved by science. And this made many people disbelieve in God altogether, disbelieve in religion altogether, or to make religion subservient to science, only accepting what their religion said if science agreed, if science cosigned, if science confirmed what the religion said, they would believe in it. If science didn't, they would believe in science and disbelieve in their religion. In Islam, brothers and sisters, there is no need for reform on this basis, because Islam has never been at odds with science. In fact, the Quran is full of scientific facts that predate scientific discoveries. For example, the development of the fetus in the womb was spoken about in the Quran. The roots of mountains going far deeper into the earth than their height, than the height of their peaks, and that these mountains serve as stabilizers for the earth. This was also spoken about in the Quran. The creation of the universe, astronomy, the ability of insects and other creatures to communicate with one another in their own special language and to impart complex concepts to one another. How bees make honey, how cattle make milk, brain function, the permanent barriers that separate rivers from seas, the movement and formation of clouds that leads to rainfall, all of these scientific facts, scientific matters, scientific knowledge has been discussed in the Quran, laid out, and all of them in accordance with latter-day scientific discoveries. So brothers and sisters, Islam is not opposed to science or the concept of there being a science to the universe, a method to the madness of the universe, a rhyme to its rhythms. Islam has never been opposed to that. Islam is not opposed to that. But what Islam does acknowledge, brothers and sisters, is that science can become a taghut, a rival deity, viewed as the supreme judge and determiner of what is right and wrong, what is true and false. And our religion warns us against adopting this view of science. Unfortunately, this view of science, which most people in the modern era have adopted, and unfortunately many Muslims have begun to adopt, that science is the supreme judge, the supreme determiner of what is right and wrong, and ultimately religion and God's words become subservient to science, subordinate to science. And we, if the religion says something, we look to science. The point, you hear some Muslims say, for example, you mention something and they'll say, well, what does the science say? What does the science say? As if to say, we're only going to accept what Allah and His Messenger have said if science says the exact same thing. Our religion warns us against adopting this view of science, making science a rival deity, brothers and sisters, and making God, the true deity, subservient to science. Allowing ourselves, brothers and sisters, to question what Allah and His Messenger have said if it apparently contradicts science. And I say apparently because science is a creation from the creations of Allah. There is no way that one of Allah's creatures is going to contradict Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters, tells us how we are supposed to function, how we are supposed to believe and conceptualize things as Muslims. We are supposed to first and foremost believe that Allah is the absolute truth. What he says is the absolute truth, and what his messenger, who was appointed to represent him and his religion, says is the absolute truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Al-haqqu min rabbik, fala takunanna min al-mumtarin. He says, the absolute truth is from your Lord, so do not be from the doubters. This comes to us from Surah Al-Baqarah, the second chapter, verse 147. Do not be from the doubters. Allah's words are the absolute truth. And if science apparently contradicts him, then science is either wrong, or it's going to take science some time to figure out that what Allah said is true. And we've seen this in many cases throughout history where science was on one side of truth, the wrong side of truth, the wrong side of science. And then they continued to work and discover and expand their knowledge. So they came to the knowledge of what? That what Allah was saying all along was truth. And the Prophet, one of his companions, he used to write down all of his record, all of his sayings, all of his traditions, as much as he could. When he ever heard the Prophet say something, he would write it down. That was Abdullah ibn Amr. And so the Quraysh, they began to make fun of him and say, you write down what the Prophet says, and he's a human being. He might be right, he might be wrong, he might be angry one day and say something out of anger, and that thing that he says would be erroneous. And so Abdullah ibn Amr, he went to the Prophet ﷺ and told him what people were saying. And basically asked him, should I really write down everything you say? Because, I mean, at the end of the day, you are human. So the Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, uktub, fawalladhi nafsi biyadi, ma kharaja minhu illa haqq. He said, record my sayings. Write down what I say. For by Allah in whose hand lies my soul, nothing exits from this mouth except the absolute truth. The absolute truth is from our Lord. The absolute truth is from our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And what we have to do, if we truly are Muslims, truly are believers, we have to believe that. And we have to understand that if the reformers are coming at us from the angle of, well, Islam seems to contradict in some areas, in some aspects, contradict science. Our answer is the truth is from our Lord, not from science. Science is subservient to Allah. Allah is not subservient to science. More on this, brothers and sisters, in the coming days. Until then, brothers and sisters, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your houses, bless your spouses, bless your children, bless your sources of livelihood and income. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless what remains of your day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and make you bless wherever you may be. Ameen, ameen, ya rabbal alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak. An nabina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.